Hello everyone, from today we are starting with our software engineering and project management subjects first unit. The first unit is introduction to the software engineering and the software process models. In this first unit, today we are going to discuss the first topic, that is software engineering fundamentals. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss the subtopics that are mentioned in this PowerPoint presentation. That is, first topic that we are going to discuss software in engineering introduction. Then we are also going to discuss the nature of software. Then software engineering principles, the software process, the software myths, and one more topic that we are going to discuss in this video, that is the software engineering importance. Okay, so let us start with the first topic, that is software engineering introduction. Before starting the introduction, we all know that what is the meaning of software. Okay, the software is nothing but the collection of programs which, when executed, they perform some kind of task. Means, when number of programs are collected together and they perform some particular kind of operation, at that time we can call it as a software. Okay, but now the question arises that what is that program, how we can define the program. Now, the program can be defined as a set of instruction. Okay, the program is called as the program is known as the collection of set of instructions, and those set of instructions, when carried out in sequential manner, they perform some kind of task, or they perform or they give some kind of output. So the set of instructions are nothing but program, and the set of programs or the bunch of programs is going to be called as an software. So we can define a software as an a product. Obviously, the product will be developed by the software engineer, and this product, by making the use of different or the various software engineering process and activities, the product can be developed by using or making use of different software engineering processes and activity. So in simple, we can define a software as a product developed by software engineering by making use of software engineering processes and the activities. Now, in the software engineering, the second term is engineering. Now, what is this engineering? The engineering is nothing but the branch of science and technology which concerned with the design, building and use of engines, machines and structure. By using this engineering, we know that we can reduce the efforts that are required to perform some kind of task. Now, in the field of software engineering or in the IT industry, the engineering will deal with the design and building of the softwares, right? We are going to design the softwares and we are going to build the softwares. Software is related to the development. If we see, we cannot construct or we cannot manufacture the software. The software can only be developed. Okay, so this is the definition of engineering, the branch of science and technology concerned with the design, building and use of engines, machines and the structure. So we can define a software engineering by using this software definition and engineering definition. Just combining these both the definition, and we will get the definition of software engineering. The software engineering is a process of analyzing users' need, then designing, constructing and testing the end user applications that will satisfy their needs through the use of software programming language. So this is nothing but the basic idea of software engineering. Then next is there, that is nature of software. How the software is going to be behave. Now, the behavior of the software can be characterized by the given four characteristics. The very important characteristic or the nature of software is reliability. The software that we are going to use, that must be reliable. If the software is reliable, then only one can use that software without hesitation. Now, what is this reliability? How we can define the reliability? The reliability can be defined as the chance of failure. As the less chance of failure is there, the reliability is high. If the chance of failure is more, then we can call it as the software is less reliable. Then second is there, that is ease of change. What is the meaning of ease of change? The meaning of ease of change, that the software can be provided with the provision to be altered at any stage of time. Means the software provides the ease of change, that means software can be altered at any stage of time. Means it can be maintained or it can be updated at any stage. Then next is there, that is rapid evaluation of technology. The software development technology and the development environments are changing rapidly. If you observe the last 2 decades, the technology has been evaluated very rapidly. Means the new technologies are coming into market, and by using those technologies, one can develop a software with the help of those technologies and different development environment. Then fourth is there, that it's low cost. The cost of software reproduction and installation is very less compared to the new development. Means once you have developed some code, the cost required for reproduction and the installation for that development is very less. Means the cost of the software development at its first stage is high, but after that the same code can be used by the reusability, and by using that reusability, the cost of software reproduction and installation gets low or get less. So low cost is also the nature of software development. Then next is there, that is software engineering principles. The below is the list of 7 software engineering principles. Whenever we are going to develop a new software, we should follow these principles. If we follow these software engineering principles, then only our software is going to meet our requirement. Okay, so the first is there, that is manage software using the phased life cycle. In the future videos or the next videos, we are going to discuss the different life cycles that can be used to develop the softwares. Okay, then those phased life cycles can be used to manage the software so that software can be maintainable, software that we are going to develop can be maintainable. Then second is there, that is perform continuous validation. At each stage, the continuous validation should be performed. Then third is there, that is maintain disciplined control on the flow of product development. There are different product development phases, and the control, disciplined control should be on that flow of product development. Then fourth is there, that is use all the innovative and modern programming practices. The innovative and new modern programming practices can be applied while developing the software. Then next is there, that is maintain all the accountability of result. Whenever we are going to gather the requirements, we also have the result in our mind. So we should keep that accountability of result. What result we are going to get at what stage? That accountability should be maintained. Then next is there, that is use the best team. The team players are very important into the team environment. So we should use the best team members to develop a product or develop a software. And the last is there, that is always maintain a commitment to improve the overall process. So these are the 7 principles that can be carried out or that can be taken into consideration while developing a software. Then next is there, that is a software process. Obviously, if we want to execute anything, that must be gone through some process. Okay, so there are different processes that are carried out to develop a software, but here we are having one framework, a software process framework, that can be illustrated with the help of given diagram. If you observe the diagram, you will find the task sets at the center of this architecture. In that, we are having tasks, then milestones, work product, and we are also having SQA points. SQA points are nothing but your software quality assurance points, means the tasks that are to be performed at the time of software development are divided into some categories and that are placed at the center as a task set. Then these task sets can be placed under the framework activities, means you just have to perform all these activities with some framework, with some process. And that process should be carried out to perform all those tasks. Then next is there, that is all those framework activities are carried out with some common process framework. The common process framework is also there, means you are going to perform the common process framework, then you are also going to perform some framework activities to perform the tasks that are executed under the software development process. There is also one more thing, that is umbrella activities. The umbrella activities includes the different 8 tasks, we can call it as a task or we can call it as a processes, okay? So umbrella activities includes the project tracking and control. The software project tracking and control, the working of that software will be tracked under this umbrella activity. Then second is there, that is risk management. Then third one is SQA. SQA is nothing but your software quality assurance, that can be also included into the umbrella activities. Then formal technical reviews, measurement, software configuration and management. The seventh is there, that is reusability management. This is also going to be very important part into the software engineering, means reusability plays very important role in the software engineering process or software development process. And the last one is there, that is work product preparation and production. The last is nothing but the preparation of the your work product. Work product means your documentation and all those things that are carried out in your last work product preparation and production. So these are the different umbrella activities that can be included under that section. So this is the software process, software development process. Then next is there, that is software myths. The software development myths can be considered at the 3 levels. The first level is management level myth. The second level is customer level myth. And the third level is practitioner level myth. We will see one example of each The management level myth is we can buy a software tool and use them. This is the myth that one can buy a software tool and use them for development of another software. The reality is software tools are the ready-made softwares and that only can help in creation or in development of the other software. A example can be there, that is nothing but your star UML software or your the type of softwares that can be used. The software can be used to develop the another software. So the myth is we can buy software tool and use them, and the reality is the software tools are only ready-made softwares that only help in creation of the other softwares. Then customer level myth. Second level, that is customer level myth. The myth is only general statement is sufficient and no need to mention the detailed project requirement. So this is the myth. But the reality is the one or the customer should provide the detailed project requirements so that a software developer can develop an appropriate software which meets the customer's need. Okay, and the third level is there, that is practitioner level myth. The practitioner level myth, the myth is once we write the program and get into work, our job is over. This is myth. Once a software developer develops a program or develops a software, that means his work is over. This is myth. This is wrong. But the reality is almost 60 to 80% work required after delivering the project. Means the reality is the work of software engineer or the software developer is also there after the delivering of the project. So these are the software myths: management level, customer level, and practitioner level. Then next is there, that is importance of software engineering. In the first slide, we discussed the software engineering. By using this process, the software engineering process, we can reduce the complexity of the program. This is the first importance, means by using software engineering, the complexity of your software, of your program can be reduced. The second is we can reduce the software cost. The software cost can be reduced by using the reusability and different software development processes. We can also reduce the software cost. Then also the development time is reduced. Again, reusability is the key factor that reduces the time required to develop a software. So these are the importance of software engineering process, and by using this software engineering process we can get this kind of things at the end of software development. So this is all about the fundamentals of software engineering. I hope you have understand. Thank you.